What is that one thing that can transform this world? That one thing is education.
At Tsai University, this active interdisciplinary model represents the future of education, not the mugging, rather thought-provoking ideas that stretch the mind and lead to a genuinely educated person who will go through life being able to seize new opportunities, create new businesses, and confront new challenges.
Neha Chowdhury, Soumya Ganti, Prakash Kumar, Abhishek Jain.
We are all proud to be a part of Tsai University.
So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Namaste and a very warm welcome to all of you to the Blub World Web Talks 153rd episode. In the last 152 episodes, we have interacted with nearly 2,500 school leaders from across the world on this very platform to know from them what's new going on in schools. So आज भी अगले 60 मिनट जो आप हमारे साथ हैं उसमें हम आपसे जानने समझने की कोशिश करेंगे कि दुनिया में शिक्षा कैसे बदल रही है और आप उसे कैसे बदल रहे हैं. So thank you so much for joining in. Before we start, I am Daksh, the founder of Blubbed World. I again welcome all of you to the 153rd episode of the Blubbed World Web Talks. Before we start, just to give you a small introduction about the platform, Blubbed World Web Talks is a bilingual platform, so you can use either English or Hindi while you converse in the whole session. Most importantly, try sticking to these two languages, because if you want to use a third one, you can, but I won't get it. So try sticking to either English or Hindi. Most importantly, this platform is not a speaking marathon. Consider it like a speaking sprint. So it's a timed platform. Once your speaking time is over, you might get muted. If you get muted, please don't get offended. It is just to finish the activity on time and keep it more entertaining and more crisp for everyone who has joined in. Never consider yourself getting muted as a disrespect of any sort. Thank you so much again for joining in. A very warm welcome into the Blub World Web Talks episode 153. And today we'll be talking about a dilemma that all of us have gone through, a dilemma that we have questioned, re-questioned, and always try to understand from ourselves as well, that have we taken the right decision? And that's the career choice, whether it should be based on our passion or it should be based on the trend that's going on. When you try to delve into these two things, aap ek cheez bahut aasani se samajh sakte hain ki kya ye ek internal process hona chahiye ya ye ek external process hona chahiye. We'll try to understand this a little bit more, that would it be a very internalized personal kind of a decision, or should it be a logic driven and external decision. So let's try to compare our career choices on passion versus trends. So let me invite the first speaker for today to set the ball rolling and to put the complete idea in context, Mr. Sailendra Swaminathan, the Dean of Division of Social Sciences and Professor of Economics from Tsai University, Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Swaminathan ji, over to you for the next 3 to 4 minutes. A very warm welcome. You can unmute yourself.
Yeah, thanks, Daksh. Pleasure to be here. And I think it's an important topic, right? I mean, as you said, I think all of us have reflected on this. I don't think there's too many people that I know that can sort of say that passion has guided their career choice. Certainly, it was not the case in my case. But I think, you know, I mean, so when you're looking at, let's just focus on the trend, right? The trend part of it. I think, you know, what is really important to understand is, see, we've heard the word trend when it comes down to something like clothing, right? Something is trendy, or shoes. And, you know, that's okay, because, you know, you're sort of like sort of saying, okay, you don't want to be the odd person out. Right. I mean, so that's sort of roughly the idea with, you know, you sort of keep pace with whatever the mass is doing. But, you know, when it comes to a career choice, I think it seems like, you know, and even though you're exactly right, that's perhaps how the bulk of us are doing it. It makes little sense, because the trend itself isn't guided by any rational choice. Right. I mean, so normally, at least in the career choice, you're looking for where are the employment opportunities. Right. And, you know, despite the fact that, you know, any reasonable person would say that, for example, with computer science degree, 7 in 10 actually would not get a job in computer science, right? I mean, that is the state of India today. You're probably going to be doing other things. So in a way, if you sort of, I mean, obviously, but that doesn't get factored in when this trend is considered, right? So it's something that is so obvious that you want to sort of figure out where is the highest probability of getting a job. You know, you sort of say, you know, it's still trendy to sort of do computer science. To me, it just sort of makes little sense. I mean, even though you're exactly right, this herd mentality, I think, pushes us to do something like that. Which is, in my opinion, I think it's perhaps a unique characteristic in India. I could be wrong. I haven't seen this in most other countries, right? And I think this idea of being a trend is, again, sort of resonates with the fact of life that, you know, we live in a crowded country, right? We move in herds. I mean, I don't think we would have space to actually sort of, you know, you talked about internalizing a decision, right? I mean, where is the space to do that? I mean, there's probably 100 people you're always connected to at all points in time. This online media has made it even worse, right? And so I think this notion of, okay, trying to understand where my passion lies, I think it's an impossible it is almost impossible for a student to be actually in that position. You know, you need the space to think about it. You need the environment. I mean, obviously, you know, we've all talked about the schools here being very much, you know, sort of obsessed with examinations. And I don't think the student actually has any chance to figure out, you know, what that passion is. So I think, you know, they're sort of caught up in a situation where passion clearly can't play a role. And the trend, I think, oftentimes is misplaced just because, as I said, you know, you don't really end up with the jobs that you're hoping you would get because, you know, you've just sort of made this mad dash to do what your neighbor is doing. So I'm going to sort of stop there, Daksh. I think it's, I'm looking forward to the rest of the conversation.
Thank you so much, Dr. Swaminathan. I think you put the complete idea in the correct perspective, because this is something that we all face, and that's the reason why we keep reconsidering our own decisions in life, that how do we plan our career trajectory. So you started with passion normally does not guide career paths in India. It's normally driven by trends, and they're also majorly by the perception of the people who are the decision makers within the household. It's rather the opportunity to decide is not given to the student or the teenager who is going to live that career throughout his life. We normally look at employment opportunities and we try to understand, okay, so this field has a lot of career opportunities, let's opt for this. But most importantly, when we even try to, you know, analyze that, the trends do not consider that. Most of the trends are based on perception rather than some reality or some research or some data based on. Space to internalize is missing. I think it's a very important aspect of life which should be taught as part of school education as well. Because if you're not able to internalize or at least trying to draw a career plan or a canvas for yourself, this time, this space should be given to a student with the right kind of guidance. I would not say the right kind of subject or training, at least some guidance or some mentoring that comes into play. So identifying passion is kind of impossible. Relying on trend, that's what we normally do, but that trend is not based on data. So that's where the choice simply becomes like a coin being tossed in the middle of the air. So I think that's why we keep questioning our own career trajectories every second day. So thank you, Dr. Swaminathan. Let me invite the next speaker for today. In the next section, we'll be talking to school leaders and trying to get their perspective, because these are the people who are in the middle of that lurch, who try to, you know, build on that limbo that keeps going on, because the student wants to know what he wants to do next, but you cannot just guide him onto content, onto career. You typically have to handhold him to the next steps that he has to take in life based on his choices, which he's not very clear about. So let me invite the first school leader for today, Ms. Anita Jairam, the senior principal of the Foundation School from Bangalore, Karnataka. Anita ji, over to you for the next 3 to 4 minutes. Please unmute yourself and a very warm welcome.
Good evening. Thank you, Mr. Darshgar, on behalf of Blub World. And good evening, all ladies and gentlemen here. A very good topic where all the parents, students, all are concerned about career choice, passion versus trend. What I would like to speak upon on this topic today is the present young generation, that is, we call the Generation Y, represent nearly a quarter of the world's population. At such a number, they are capable of reshaping the world for now and for the decades to come. So for them, it is a big choice how to make the choice. It's a big concern for the parents as well as the students who are after plus two, they don't know which subject, which stream to take. choosing a path, selecting where to invest their time and energy, how to make the choices, the ones that are best for each person from all the rest. So that's a big concern for everyone nowadays. What I would like to say is, as students, they should find their own passion. Doing work that you love makes a huge difference in their life. Identify the preferences, the environment you would like to be, the contentment, the happiness which you will get, the compensation you desire for, the connectivities you make, the communications, etc. Now target your place, whether you want to be an entrepreneur, a startup, a government service, a corporate in corporate sector, medical field, engineering field, or in educational field. As far as I'm concerned, from day one, that is after my 10th standard, I was bound to be a teacher. I had made up my mind and I love the passion now also. Align the practical realities, the various factors to pursue your goals. Now, to the various factors to pursue your goals, as schools, we have to build the skill developments in students at a very young age. That's a preparation to tap their inner abilities, I should say. What are they passionate about, their creativity, and what do they enjoy doing? So nowadays in CBSE, we have the different types of skills that are tested for children. That is, we test on communication skills. We have various activities for it. Critical thinking and problem solving. The question paper itself has been changed with case studies and other things. Adaptability and agility. How they can, with their peer groups, how they can adapt themselves, the agility, the initiative to take up of responsibility, accessing and analyzing information. So project works are given, the curiosity and the imagination which has to be developed from a very young age, and the love to learn new things. With all these things, I feel by the time they reach around 16 or 17, they will be able to figure out what profession they want to pursue. So this is what I want to say. As schools, we have, for the new generation, schools are gearing up for all this, and I'm sure they'll find a perfect job. So it's not the age where we had our education, but the present generation has a lot of opportunities in front of them. Yeah, that's what I want to say. Yeah, thank you so much for giving me an opportunity.
Thank you so much, Anita ma'am. I'll try to summarize what you said. The generation Y is a quarter of the world. दुनिया की पॉपुलेशन 6 billion से ज्यादा है एंड उसमें एक बहुत बड़ा चंक इज द जनरेशन वाई दैट वी आर राइट नाउ प्रोसेसिंग वी वुड से रादर क्योंकि अब सारी डेटा ड्रिवन लैंग्वेज है सो इट्स टीचिंग और प्रोसेसिंग दिस इज समथिंग दैट वी नीड टू डिफरेंशिएट मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंटली हाउ टू चूज इज अ कंसर्न एंड आई थिंक दिस एज अ स्किल हैज टू बी टॉट डिसीजन मेकिंग एज अ स्किल हैज टू बी टॉट बिफोर यू एक्चुअली यू नो पोज और गिव हिम द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ फाइंडिंग हिज पैशन प्रेफरेंस सैटिस्फैक्शन कॉम्पनसेशन कम्युनिटी कम्युनिकेशन एंड वेयर डज ही फाइंड हिमसेल्फ इन द फ्यूचर I think choosing the right thing or giving him a little bit of wisdom, that's, I think, a wisdom should now be considered a skill. It should not be considered a value. It should be considered a skill. And we should find more structured and empirical ways of teaching wisdom to children so that they can draw a small little drawing that tells them something about their own futures. So the various factors that will help them in identification is trying to, again, you know, look at how they look at life, the goals that they look at, the skills that they want to develop, the passion that they have, and most importantly, their creativity and curiosity. Because these two factors typically decide our attitude towards life. If we are creative enough, if we are curious enough, we try to know new things, we try to do new things. But if we are complacent, and if you want to have a more satisfied and a more relaxed life, then the decision-making changes dramatically. Case studies have found space in the question papers, and I think they should also find space in the daily classrooms that come up. There should be a lot of storytelling that should happen, because humans are made that ways. We always want to, you know, establish that cause and effect relationship, because our decision making is based on just these factors. Once we establish a cause and effect, that's where the decision making happens. Access and analysis of information. Children nowadays have a lot of information with them, but the challenge again is analysis. That's what's not being taught, and I think that should be focused a little bit more on. Thank you so much, Anita ma'am, for adding these ideas and perspectives to the discussion. Let me invite the next speaker for today, Mr. Prasad Don Gaonkar, the principal of KLE School from Bangalore, Karnataka. Prasadji, over to you for the next 3 to 4 minutes. A very warm welcome.
Thank you. Namaste, everyone. Hi. See, the thing is, what I feel the present generation is spoiled for choices. And as you rightly said, many of the students have a lot of information with respect to what they want to do or what they can. But what I have always understood is, you know, following the passion doesn't always translate into a high paying job. And today, many of us, we translate success in terms of how much is the earning. And when I say we, I'm talking about a general population. So one's work does not necessarily involve a path of self-satisfaction. Sometimes I feel when we are with students, the kind of impact that we make on them changes the path. I think I can share with a very small anecdote of one of my kid, a student. Till the 6th and 7th standard, whenever I asked her, what do you want to do? She always used to say, I want to become a cardiologist. As she came to the 7th, later half, the second half of the year, I took her to MUN, and later on she found her strength, her passion. Today, she has cracked the CLAT 2021, and that was her passion, getting into National Law School, Bangalore. She is All India, rank 66, and Karnataka 8. And she has written such a beautiful note for me at 1 o'clock in the morning when the results were announced. I can feel the joy and happiness that she has. See, as far as trending is concerned, most of the kids, you know, because their friends are doing something, they also want to do. Nowadays, what I have seen is, you know, since I talk to the students, most of them want to get into something called as work that is technology related, like user experience and user interface, or digital media and marketing, or event managers. Teaching profession comes in the last. Most of them want to become engineers or doctors, just because their friends go in and they see success. You know, we glorify those who have been doing absolutely well in their fields. But many a times I do tell them that these are some of the things that you can definitely look at, like, you know, UI and UX, because this is what is going to be the thing in the coming years. At the same time, they need to understand what are the earning potentials when they speak of or when they talk about their passion. I'm sure they'll be able to make both the ends meet if they're passionate about it. I'm sure, as Anita madam was saying, that though they are spoiled for choices, they definitely get one or the other job. I think I have crossed 3 minutes. Thank you, Daksh. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Prasadji. Let me try to summarize what you said. Present generation is actually having a very big platter of choices where they need to choose. But their choice is normally driven by emotion and not by intelligence. And that's where the big challenge comes in. They rather go behind the glorification and what their friends are doing, the peer pressure, rather looking into the information that affects them, that would affect their career trends or their career trajectory. And what you rightly said, passion normally does not translate into money. And when we try to gauge success, we equate it to money. The more money you have, the more successful you are, the more satisfied you are. And the story that you already told about a student from being, you know, thinking of being a cardiologist to an MUN and finally cracking the CAT. So this is the typical trajectory of a student. And I think this should be the trajectory, that you are able to explore more. You're able to, you know, meddle around with things. You're able to do things. And this space and time must be available to all the students who are there in the school so that they make a better choice. You talked about UI, UX, digital marketing, digital technology. I think these are the, I would say rather, fad words in the career arena. And at the same time, these are the popular career choices that people are making, because we see a lot of technology around us. But I think we have forgotten that there are some primary fields that are missing people at the moment, We need people in agriculture sciences. We need people in genome technology. So I think the exploration should be a little bit more wider. It should be more data driven. And more importantly, it should, again, induce some form of wisdom in the child. It should not be just information. It should be coupled up with meaningful learnings coming out of it. So thank you so much, Prasadji. Let me invite the next speaker for today, Mrs. Anupama Ramchandra, Principal, Delhi Public School, Electronic City, Bangalore. Anupama ji, over to you for the next 3 to 4 minutes. Please unmute yourself and a very warm welcome.
Very, very good evening. And thank you, Daksh, for allowing me to speak. So since, you know, we are speaking about this dilemma, so the first question we have to ask ourselves is this dilemma new? Or has it been there for a very, very long time? So I think we all know the answer that this dilemma has been there, is there, will be there. You know, this conflict between helping our students choose what they want to do in the later part of their life is something that we have to keep, you know, discussing over and over again. And one thing that all of us should admit or confess is that as a nation, as a people, we don't pay much attention to being happy doing what we do, whether we want to call it a career, whether we want to call it a job, you know. So that is the first difference that we have to talk about, that are we pushing our kids, are we encouraging our children to take up a job, or are we encouraging them to take up a career? So the difference is plain and simple. A job is something that we do as a means of livelihood, and a career is something that we do for life. So if we, you know, in very simple terms, I like to simplify everything that I come up with in life or whatever I encounter. So in plain simple words, if we encourage our children to take up a career to make a living, I think the answer to this dilemma is got. And, you know, it is so important to find out whether they will continue to be happy if they take up whatever they are doing for a living. So we would rather have an unhappy dentist, because that is, you know, more rewarding. And, you know, it has what we call a status in the society, an unhappy dentist rather than have a happy teacher. I give this example many times because I have a dentist turned teacher in my school. You know, after many years of being a dentist, she decided that she wanted to give teaching a try because she always felt that there was a calling in her. And once she took it up, she did it for 2 years to see whether she likes it or not. And today she is one of our best teachers because she went on to do her BEd. And today she's an academic coordinator in our school. So this is my take on this, that we have to just find out, you know, all children come with a certain skill set. You know, we have to identify what are they, you know, are they good speakers? Are they good at calculations? Are they a people's person? Do they like the arts? Do they like architecture? Do they like growing plants? You know, there are so many fairs that happen. So I was just finishing what I was saying by saying that it is so important for us to encourage children and tell them that it is good that you have to, you know, live, I mean, work for a living, but you also have to be happy at doing that. So for me, you know, the word that I want to underline and mark it in bold is happiness. Happiness in doing what we do every day. So I think that is what we need to promote. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Anupama. Let me try to summarize what you said. Is the dilemma new or something that has existed for a long time? I think it's an evergreen question that always remains relevant. That should it be the trend or should it be the passion? Because what we've all learned through the harsh experience of life is that money matters the most. And passion normally does not translate into money. But I think a little bit of what we can say, thoda sa chonk laga dena chahiye usme passion ka, so that there's some level of satisfaction that you draw out of your careers. It's not just for livelihood, but it's for your life. So that it contributes to you as a personality, it contributes to you as a family. so that while you grow with the money coming in, you also grow emotionally and you're happy throughout. You talked about conflict of choice of life. I think you have to talk more about how to demystify this conflict, how to make it a little more empirical, finding small little ways that could help them explore more, understand more, because during the complete education process that goes through in the school, we do not put a lot of time on this topic, or rather give them the space and time to think on this, that how would you make that choice? What would you be considering while you make this choice? Then you talked about taking up a job or a career. That's a very good way of summarizing the complete dilemma, that think of something that satisfies you and at the same time gives you a lot of money. Then you went to the story of an unhappy dentist rather than a happy teacher, and you have a dentist who's a teacher right now. Finding the child's passion and working to be happy, not just for being paid. So thank you so much, Anupama ji. Let me invite the next speaker for today, Dr. Sujata Girish, founder, principal and CBSE resource person, Daffodils Foundation for Learning, Bangalore, Karnataka. Sujata ji, over to you for the next 3 to 4 minutes. Please unmute yourself and a very warm welcome.
Greetings to one and all present on the virtual platform. First of all, I would like to congratulate BlubWorld for picking up a very relevant topic and at the right time, I must say, because I'm sure the students have received their board results, 12th standard board results. They are contemplating on what next, what should be the road to be taken next. I would like to begin my words with a quote quoted by Confucius. Choose a job you love and you will never have to work a day in your life, I unquote. I personally feel the career choices should be based on what one considers as success or ambition of life. And again, success is a relative term. Success is perceived as different things by different people. For some, it is the remuneration, the money. For some, it is the ambition of life. And for some, it is a position in a particular company. And for some, like me, it is a job satisfaction. They feel at the end of the day, when I go to bed, they should feel satisfied about what they did that particular day. They should feel, yes, I have made a difference to the society in small little ways. And probably that is what I can call it as passion. And morning, when they wake up, they should have that springing action in themselves. Something within them should push them to reach the venue of work and not drag their feet towards the destination of work. So people probably who seek money, position, and who are very ambitious might want to choose the trends. People who translate success in terms of money, probably who want to climb the ladders of their career, might want to translate it as trends. But at the same time, there are quite a few people who seek job satisfaction as their success. They consider job satisfaction as a successful criteria to define their success. They would like to follow their heart. They would like to consider their passion. I think it works well when we take some anecdotes, because storytelling is something which appeals to everyone's heart and mind. Farhan Qureshi of Three Idiots, I'm sure he is a very well-known character, one of the three famous protagonists of the movie. He is eligible to be an engineer, and he is supposed to be the alumni of a very reputed technical institution of the country. But then his passion is photography. Finally, he quits the trend and chooses to follow his passion. Like him, there are many people who pick trends in the beginning, and later they repent and they try to go back to their passion. I would like to quote myself as another example. I hold a doctorate in English literature. And when I joined my doctoral degree, many of my peers in the university would ask me, after doing PhD, why would you like to continue in the school as a principal? And I would like to tell them, school is a place where you interact with the young minds, the most important resource of any country, that is a human resource. You can bring in a change. You can contribute to the society at the root level. This is where my passion lies for me. And at the end of the day, I feel I have been able to influence a few young minds. I have been able to make a difference. This is what is my passion. What do we do in the school towards this? We do conduct career guidance sessions. We do educate our students about the current trends, about the latest trends, about the changing trends, because the world is constantly evolving. Thanks to pandemic, a lot of changes have been happening in the job scenario, the career options. We do create an awareness regarding everything. At the same time, we advise them to follow their heart, follow their passion, because I consider life is very precious. Children should.
Thank you so much, Sujata ma'am. The first 4 minutes are over. We'll try to come back to you again, but some amazing points you've put up. So let me try to summarize what you said. Choosing a job that you love, and you will never work for a day in your life. I think Confucius demystified this question long back, but money rather plundered the idea of it in a very weird way. And that's where our decision making, our wisdom went for a complete toss. Success is relative, and most importantly, it's perceptive. People understand it from their own perspective of things, their own reality of things, the way they see the world. Most importantly, we should find and try to, you know, give students a focus on them finding one factor that will keep them encouraged throughout their life to go to work every single morning, and not make it an activity that bores them down, that bogs them down. I think this is where the idea of ikigai falls correctly, a reason to jump out of your bed every single morning. So thank you so much, Sujata ma'am. Let me invite the next speaker for today, Mrs. Katyayani Bhatt, Principal, Vishwa Pranja Academy from Bangalore, Karnataka. Katyayani ma'am, over to you for the next 4 minutes. Please unmute your audio, and a very warm welcome.
Namaste. I'm very happy to be here today. And passion is very close to my heart. And we try to propagate to make children very passionate in our institution, because passion gives originality. And passion is a competition within yourself. And we should really trust our passion. That is what we teach our children. And then we can make good service, and they can take up a good career or a good life. So many a times we have to choose between passion and trend. And a very difficult choice indeed. Which road to be taken? The same dilemma as in The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. So especially in the school like ours, where we have heterogeneous group of students, rural and urban, we have to give them all kinds of career guidance so that they can choose the right choice as per their passion. So what gives you that most satisfaction by the end of the day or in the long run? And we ask children, should you run after a goal which is not your choice and not your cup of tea? Or should you carry a milestone around your neck throughout? So contentment is very, very important. That is what in my long service I have recognized and acknowledged. So trend makes you compete with others. Many a times it becomes unhealthy, and it is never ending, because trend keeps changing. And keeping people happy throughout, that is very, very important. So positive trend is welcome. And I would like to say is the best solution is balance and blend both passion and trend together and make it a part of life. So we need to eventually and gradually make the children understand that let them take the right career or right kind of skill and other things, so that in the long run they are contented and happy in their life. And sometimes even if they have taken up a job, and in their later part of life they switch on to agriculture and farming and so many other things that I have seen with my own eyes. So these are the things I would like to tell with my experience. And the flame of passion should be always sustained in the students, and they should not extinguish that kind of training. And in the schools, we give a lot of, we call people from different walks of life, in military and music and so that they can get the first-hand information from them and they can understand the experience that they have gone through in their life. So that becomes very easy and children understand better. They ask a lot of questions to them and their queries are always answered by these people. So this is the way how we are taking these things in our school. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kathayani, ma'am. Let me try to summarize what you said. Run after a goal or carry a milestone. I think this rather summarizes it very well, that try to think of an activity, try to think of a career that you think that you'll carry proud, with a lot of proud and pride within you, rather than just trying to fight for something that everybody is going around. Passion makes you satisfied, but trend keeps you fighting. And most importantly, trends keep changing. But your career trajectory is something that will stay with you. But with the kind of advent that's happening in education and all around us, because of this COVID, we've all understood that we'll all have multi-career life. And when we'll have a multi-career life, we also have to understand that how will we be balancing the trend and the passion and finding a path that keeps both of these ends satisfied, or rather money and satisfaction balanced. And you have been using the story mechanism quite well in your school by inviting professionals to share their experience of their life. So thank you so much, Kathayani, ma'am. Let me invite the next speaker for today, Mr. Faisal Wahab, the principal of Mother's Care High School from Adilabad, Telangana. Faisal ji, over to you for the next 4 minutes. Please unmute your audio and a very warm welcome.
Thank you, sir. In my opinion, first of all, welcome to all the participants. So everyone has given their own views, and I think it was maximum. I think everyone has talked on the passion and trend. So I will start up with the famous writer whose name is Robert Kiyosaki, and he has written the book Rich Dad and Poor Dad, where he describes how the passion and the purpose of the life we should carry. And generally he teaches to the students and to all the people. So where he says that purpose and passion. So if as he's a financial advisor, and he says that the school must start the teaching the financial aspects of the life and the skills which every student required to earn the money. Means he focuses specially on the purpose of the life. So what he says that passion or a purpose of the life means if you want your passion, if you want to back up your passion, then you may not be a financially stable person in the life. But what is the purpose? Why you want your passion? So he describes it that your main intention is to get the money, to earn the money and to live the happy life. That's what he says. So overall there are, but in my personal view, as we are fully aware then, there is a different psychology in the students. Students, few students and the few children, they will back especially to financial attitude. Means they have the ability, they want more money. And they are a little bit passionate to earn the financial freedom. And when it comes to the few students, they are more passionate and they want the name and fame. Like they want to become passionate about their own creativity, what they have, rather than moving towards the financial aspect. So here, as a teacher, as a principal, as an educator, it is our responsibility to understand what the student wants. Whether they want the passion or they want the trend. So it is our own responsibility. And whatever, suppose how much we will guide them, how much we will train them. But bottom line is that at last, they will work upon their psychology. They will work upon their own thinking and their own beliefs and their own thought processing, which they have got it right from their childhood. So it's up to the environment where they are staying, and it's up to the generally to the parents. Suppose a child is from a business background. So he is more passionate to just move towards a business and earn the money instead of rather than he's not at all thinking about the passion, what he has. He don't want to think actually, because I have many students, even if they are in the sixth class or fifth class, they will move to the along with the parents in the business and they will help them. And they will never think about their own passion. They could do better as a passionate, whatever they have the creativity. But they will focus on the their own business. Means their purpose of the life is they want to earn the money. So here the psychology of the student environment, which we have learned in B.Ed., I think so, it concerns a lot when as a child grows as a human being. I hope I have kept the point. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Faisal. Let me try to summarize what you said. You started with Robert Kiyosaki's book, Rich Dad and Poor Dad, where he tries to balance the passion and purpose of life. He tells that the purpose of life would be rather making a lot of money and being happy with it. And the passion can be carried on that money. This is something that you can have even ahead in life, but money is something that you have to start earning. And I think that's where the idea of financial literacy becomes very important. We must teach people, we must teach children that how does money move? How does money travel? Because once you understand how money travels, you'll understand that how does it come into a profit and loss statement? How does it go into a balance sheet? And how does it exit a balance sheet? The definition of an asset for a salaried guy and for a business person is very different. And that's what typically happens in the complete Rich Dad Poor Dad book. He tries to put definitions of these two in the most candid way of explaining the difference between these two and the perceptions that are attached to these two for salaried people and for business people. Once we put in financial literacy as part of curriculum, we'll be able to find a very good, a very more empirical, a more logical solution to this question of career choice, whether it should be the passion versus the trend. So thank you so much, everybody. We listened to all the speakers for now. Now the next 3 to 4 minutes is an open floor. It's for all the speakers. If you got muted, if you missed out to something, if you want to add something to the complete discussion, it's over to you. So all the speakers for today, you can unmute yourself. You can, add something if you want to do it right away, or we can move into the next section of the discussion. I would request Swaminathanji for his closing thoughts.
No, I think some wonderful points that were raised, sort of real eye-openers, because, there's one point about, the fact that, normally, even though trends might initially dictate, what we end up doing, for some lucky people, passion dominates at some point, and you sort of are able to switch tracks, which is, I think, highly commendable. I mean, to the extent that can be done, but I think still that is a minority. I mean, I think overall, most of us, we get sort of onto one track, and you continue on that. Life, pushes you along. So I mean, but I think that's a point well taken, that passion finally can, as we be pursued. And the other point, I mean, some really nice stories about talking about from personal experience about the student who, at that young age, and that's an adolescent age when you're talking about, you want to be a cardiologist or a doctor. And then at some point, something sort of opens your mind, in this case, sort of to switch on to law, and to do so well in the exam. I think at some level, one should be really passionate about that. But I think overall, great discussion. Thanks very much.
Thank you so much, Sarindaji. I think Sujatha, ma'am, wanted to add something, ma'am. You can unmute yourself.
The whole world is talking about mental health these days. A lot of discussion is happening about happiness quotient, mental health, emotional health. In fact, recently in the Tokyo Olympics, one of the gymnasts decided to, call it a day at the final level. That is because she was not able to handle the mental pressure. So if we have to take lesson from these realities, real incidents, I believe ultimately what keeps you happy end of the day, the child should be encouraged to make that as a choice. It could be a trend, it could be a passion. Ultimately, the student should be able to live with that choice all his life or her life and live happily. That's it from my end. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, Sujataji. And yes, I think what keeps you happy, trying to find the answer to this would be giving you an answer to your career choice, or how would you be choosing your career. So we have listened to all the speakers for today, tried to put together their ideas on how would you choose your career, how would you look at life, or rather how would you look at livelihood and your life, or trying to find your ikigai or reason that will keep you up, or rather give you a reason to get up every single morning. Now, as we do and as is customary in all these Blub World Web Talks, we conclude these talks with a small story of a teenager who has done amazingly well, because we believe in something that teaching has now to transform itself into inspiring. because stories are what keeps us moving, and stories is something that we learn quickly and we rather adapt in our lives very quickly. So one such small story for all of you about a girl who started her painting career when she was just 9 months old. She had her first exhibit at the age of 2, which was a complete sold-out show. She had her next exhibit at the age of 7, which was also a complete sold-out show. And then at age 9, she was invited to one of the biggest and the most respected galleries of New York to again put an exhibit, which was also a sold-out show. She found her life and passion, and right now is only 13 years old and is a millionaire, lives in Melbourne, Australia, has never been to a school, and that was on the cover page of Blub World just some months back, and that was Elita Andre, who's known as the world's youngest professional painter. And that's what we do every month, try to find a teenager who's doing amazingly well and try to share their stories with many more teens across the world. Since 1 year, we are trying to build the world's first and the biggest parliament of teenagers. So invite you, your students, everyone to become a part of the World Teen Parliament, which is supported by UNESCO New Delhi Office and the UNESCO Mahatma Gandhi Institute. Most importantly, the Teen Parliament is a parliament of solutions. We are inviting students to solve local and global problems, and we will be funding their ideas. And most importantly, nobody pays anything to participate in the parliament other than their intelligence. Thank you so much for being a part of the Blub World Web Talks. Before this comes to an end, if you enjoyed the session and if you want to attend the future ones, you can open your audio, say a big yes, and thank you so much for being a part of the Blub World Web Talks 153rd edition on Career Choice. Thank you so much, people. Namaste.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
It's a wonderful session.
You are a part of this World in Parliament, and it is an amazing initiative. We are with Blub World in this journey. We would like to be a part of it. Thank you once again.
Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you. Have an amazing evening ahead.
Thank you, everyone.
What is that one thing that can transform this world? That one thing is education.
At Tsai University, this active interdisciplinary model represents the future of education, not the mugging, rather thought-provoking ideas that stretch the mind and lead to a genuinely educated person who will go through life being able to seize new opportunities, create new businesses, and confront new challenges.
Sneha Chowdhury,
Soumya Gandhi,
Prash Kumar, Abhishek Jain.
We are all proud to be a part of Tsai University.